to all. Now we will see what is meant by kinship and what are the importances of kinship and why it is important for the existing society. So let us see first what is meant by kinship. So kinship is the social relationship that derive from the blood ties or the relationship that comes from the marriage. We can see that kinship or the relationship that exists everywhere in the world and it is universal. So kinship plays a major part, especially in the process of socialization of individuals, because through the relationship only we can learn the things from the elders, from the parents, from the peer groups. So, and moreover, kinship plays a major role, especially in the simple or the primitive societies. Even now we can see in rural areas or in primitive society how people give much importance for the relationship and how to respect the relationship, everything that you can learn only from the simple society. Then in modern society, the kinship or the relationship that we have to search at present, because from the children to the elders, everyone start to spend their time in the technology, because after the development of science and technology, people do not they are not ready to know the value of relationship, particularly the parental relationship, because children are spending their time especially with the mobile, by chatting or any social media. So it is so we have to see, actually this is a right time to study about the kinship or the relationship for the welfare of the children as well as the future generation. Next, we'll see what is the definition of kinship. So A.R. Radcliffe Brown says that kinship is a system of dynamic relations that existing between person and person in a community. The behavior of any two persons in any of these relations being regulated in some way and to a greater or less extent by social usage. So it is a dynamic it studies about the dynamic relationship between the persons in a group or in even in a community. Next, let us see what are the different types of kinships are there. Kinships or the relationship can be evaluated through various process. The first one is consanguineous kinship. So these kinds of kinships or the relationship which can be derived or which can come from the blood ties. Example, you can see these kinds of relationship, particularly nuclear family, like after their marriage they get a child, like a daughter or son with the father and mother. So these are the examples for consanguineous kinship. Next, we'll see what is mean by the affinal kinship. So the relationship or kinship that comes from the marriage is called as affinal kinship. Like for example, the relationship of husband and wife, the relationship of the relationship that comes from the mother's side or the wife's side or from the husband's side, like a father-in-law or mother-in-law or a brother-in-law, like that. So these are the examples for affinal kinship. Now we'll see what is meant by descent. So descent is a group or it is a social unit that can be identified by the common ancestor in reality or in imagine. So descent, which refers the social recognition of the biological relationship that exists between the individuals. For example, group of individuals may be living in a particular community. So an individual can be identified by asking their ancestor. Like for example, even if you go to your friend's house, so the people will ask your friends. The people in your friend's house will ask which god that you are worshipping, because they want to know your community and they want to identify your community. So they are asking the name of the god that you are worshipping. So through that they will identify which community or which descent that you belong. So there are three important rules are there to identify to identify the descent. The first one is patrilineal descent. Here, an individual can identify his ancestor through the male line or through the father line, which means the ancestor or the god of goddesses maybe will be coming from the male line, like grandfather or any forefathers like that. Then the matrilineal descent. Here you can see the descent will be identified by the mother side or female line. Like for example, in Kerala, you can see mostly because that the society which exists in Kerala gives importance for the matrilineal descent. So that you can take an example for matrilineal descent. Next one is bilateral descent, where you can see either mother side or father side, or even both you can identify through bilateral descent. So why should we have the descent? So it helps to identify his biological factors. And next one, it establishes for the individual a network of social position in which he participates. Next, he comes to know about his obligations and rights. The next rule will help to identify the rights of inheritance. Like for example, in matrilineal society, especially grandson will have the rights to get the property of their forefathers. Likewise, in matrilineal society, especially granddaughters will have the rights to get the property of their grandmothers. So this is how it goes. And next, so relationship or kinship will function based on the closeness or the intimacy that we can say. So based on the intimacy or based on the proximity, we can classify the kinship into three types. The first one is primary kinship. So under primary kinship, we can say that there are eight types of primary relationships are there. And we have to know first what is my primary relationship or primary kinship. So the relationship that comes based on the blood ties are called as primary relationship. Examples are father or daughter, mother and son, then daughter and father or siblings we can say. Next we'll see what is secondary kinship. So there are 33 types of secondary kinships are there. First let us know what is meant by secondary kinship. So secondary kinships or the relationship which comes through the marriage is called a secondary relationship or secondary kinship. Example, wife's mother or a brother's wife or sister's husband, like an individual's secondary relationships are called as secondary kinship. Then next one is tertiary kinship. Tertiary kinship refers this secondary kin of one's primary kinship. For example, a husband's brother's wife, a brother's wife's sister. So these are the example for tertiary kinship. So anthropologists are saying that there are nearly 151 tertiary kinships are there. Next, lineage. Actually, lineage is a unilineal descent group in which membership may rest either patrilineal or matrilineal. So here we can say that like ancestor, we can say the relationship or the membership can be identified through matrilineal or patrilineal, but not in both way. Any one can be identified. Next, clan or civ. So this is a unilineal descent group, the members of which may claim either patrilineal descent or matrilineal descent from a founder, but do not identify the ancestor or ancestors. So in clan, it's nothing than the cluster of families, but which cannot identify its original ancestor or ancestral through the biological things. So they can identify their ancestor through patrilineal side, which means a male side or female side. Next, fratry. It is a grouping of clans. So we have seen that clan is a group of family, whereas fratry is a group of clans which are related to traditions of common descent. So it is a group of clans which consist or which is having a one common descent. It may be either patrilineal side or matrilineal line. Then moieties refers to the bisection of society into two complementary social groups. Next, kinship usages. Why should we have kinship usages? We should know all these things. First, to create or to form a group. Next, kinship helps us to govern the relationship, like how to behave to whom. All these things will be explained by the kinship, so we need it. So the first one is rule of avoidance. Rule of avoidance: two kings of opposite sex should avoid each other. Like for example, in different tribal communities there will be regulations that would brother and sister shouldn't be together in a room. Like for example, in Tamil society we can see that mother-in-law or daughter-in-law, they won't be in a room because they're not allowed to be in a room, like mother-in-law and then son-in-law. Okay, and then joking relationship. So this involves a combination of friendliness and antagonism between individuals or groups. So this kinds of relationship that you can see among the granddaughter and grandfather, because they will take in charge and they will share so many things which cannot be shared to the parents. So this relationship is called as a joking relationship. Next one is taxonomy. Here a kin is not referred directly, but a kin or the relationship will be called by the name of referred through the another kin. Like for example, in Tamil society we can say that wife will not call her husband by their name. Like for example, my mom used to call my dad like Suganya's daddy. This is how they will call, and they will not say their parent husband's name directly. So this is known as taxonomy. And next one is enclave. So here a special relationship that persists in some societies between a man and his mother's brother. Like for example, in Tamil society we used to give much importance for the mother's brother, especially in village or in rural area you can see. So women give priority only for, and even decisions taken by the family should be accepted by first. It should be accepted by the mother's brother first, and then only they will implement it. And next one is amitate. So amitate gives a special role to father sister. So here it gives the importance role or the priority to the relationship of father sister. So here in family, whatever the decisions taken by the family should be accepted by father sister, then they will finalize it. Even especially in the in case of marriages also, in case of marriages and all, they will give priority to get married within the father's sister children. Next, covert. So this involves the relationship between only the husband and wife. Thank you. So this is the reference book.